We're going to be talking about faithfulness. Look at a neighbor who is next to you and tell that neighbor, neighbor, faithfulness. I told you you're sitting next to a Philistine. That's why they're not responding. Talk to the other one and tell that neighbor, 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 are you faithful? Ask them, are you faithful? Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Faithfulness, ladies and gentlemen, is, thank you, Jillian, is an important ingredient in your Christian journey. What? Faithfulness. Hallelujah. I knew I wasn't going to get many amens, so I came with my own amen. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Talk to a neighbor and tell that neighbor, neighbor, I hope you are a faithful man or woman. Hallelujah. Jesus talks to us about faithfulness. And faithfulness, ladies and gentlemen, is such an important key in your life. Because as you go up to heaven, what will they tell you? Thou good and it seems this side they've not been doing Bible study. Baba J, you are Royako. Amen. What shall he say? Thou? Thou good and faithful servant, enter now into my what? Into my glory. Hallelujah. And so what will be then? Faithfulness is key. Talk to another neighbor who is next to you and tell them faithfulness is key. Faithfulness is one of the major keys as you begin to walk with God. And that's what I want us to do in the next two or three Sundays. We're going to be talking about faithfulness. And we're going to be seeing what Jesus Christ says about what? Faithfulness. I want us to move quickly to the book of Luke chapter 16. Luke chapter 16. We're going to start there. Luke chapter 16 in Jesus' mighty name. Cast it up there. Luke chapter 16, that's where we're going to start in Jesus' mighty name. We're going to see Jesus Christ talking about faithfulness, and we're going to see what he says in Jesus' mighty name. I don't have a lot of time, so today we're just going to read scriptures, and then we're going to be done for today in Jesus' name. Is it there?
Jesus told his disciples.
Hey, we are reading together. One, two, go.
Jesus told his disciples. There was a rich man.
Whose manager was accused of wasting his possessions. Look at a neighbor who is next to you and tell that neighbor, 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 I hope you are not one who wastes. Turn to the other one because... have you turned to the other one? Are you talking to them? Please tell them, hey, Buana, don't waste. Don't waste. Don't waste money. Don't waste resources. Don't usiwaste mafuta kwa kitchen. Sasa bwana sifiwe. 5 liters ina bwana sifiwe. Talk to a neighbor. Steamer unatumia bwana sifiwe. Unakaa kwa shower. You're just singing there. Steamer ina you're just dancing. Talk to the other neighbor and tell that neighbor, neighbor, please. Tokens are not for you only. Mwambie, we know that you have to be clean. You're not telling them. Bwana sifue. For those of us who are driving, you rev that car, ikitoka kwa lights, nobody sees it, can't see me. Talk to a neighbor and tell that neighbor, pole pole. You will get there. Drive pole pole. You're wasting fuel all over the place. Metuachia moshi in the city. Now we have to, there is global warming because of your wasting. Can we go to verse number 2? What does verse number 2 say?
So he called him and asked him.
Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, listen to me. Even when you are wasting, we will call you to account. And even more so, God will call you to account. Bwana sifiwe. I know you don't want to hear this one, but I want to tell you today. God will call you to do what? To account for the things that he has done what? Given you. Hallelujah. And also it gives us a model. When you have a problem with someone, call them. Wacha kuniongelea na huko. Call me. What did the master do? He called him. He didn't just say, say, hey, I knew this guy. I knew when I was employing him. No, he didn't respond to the people who told him. What did he do? He called him. Talk to a neighbor and tell that neighbor, neighbor, when you have a problem with someone, call them. Talk to them. Talk to the other one and tell them when you are talked to. Accept also. Amen. Listen to what he says. So he called him. We are reading together.
He called him in and asked him, what is this I hear about you? Give an account of your management, because you cannot be manager any longer.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, it is a bad thing for God to elevate you. But because of your unfaithfulness, you can no longer be his manager anymore. Have you not seen people who were elevated into certain positions, but because of their, they are no longer in that place. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to understand, you need to be careful when God blesses you, because he calls to account the things that he gives you. Don't you know that Jesus Christ says, to all that you have given me, to the 12, I have kept them apart from one who is the son of perdition. Even Jesus gave an account of the 12. Hallelujah. If Jesus can give an account. Bwana sifiwe. Talk to a neighbor who is next to you and ask that neighbor, neighbor, can you account for the gifting of God over your life? I told you that one is a Philistine. Ask the other one. Hey, Mwaliza Bwana, can you account? Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Because listen, ladies and gentlemen, sometimes there is a season of abundance that comes into our lives where we have 7 fat cows. And when God blesses you with 7 fat cows, it is because there are 7 skinny ones that are coming. So if you are not faithful with the 7 fat ones, the 7 skinny ones will finish you. Talk to a neighbor and tell that neighbor, neighbor, you look like you're in your season of abundance. Be prudent. I talk to the other one, be prudent. You can't just unauma piece ya kuku Java unasema this Java, I'm going to another Java. Unaacha hiyo chakula hapo na unalipa. Unamwambia nini nimeenda? We naingia Kenchik, unauma hivi moja unasema hizi chips hazijapikwa vizuri. I'll leave them here. Uliingia ukifanya nini? We. You must be faithful with the things that God gives you. Because one day, God will call to account the things that he has given you. What did you do with them? Amen? Verse number 3, let's go.
What shall I do now? My master is taking away my job. I'm not strong enough to dig, and I'm ashamed to beg.
Do you see what has happened? Because of his lack of faithfulness, time imeenda. Now he's no longer a young man. He cannot dig anymore. And he is too old to beg. That's why he's getting ashamed. That's why I'm calling you today into this place and space of faithfulness. Talk to a neighbor and tell that neighbor, neighbor, be faithful with what God gives you. What happens thereafter?
I know what I'll do so that when I lose my job here, people will welcome me into their houses. So he called in each one of his master's debtors. He asked the first, how much do you owe my master? 900 gallons of olive oil, he replied.
The manager told him,
take your bill, sit down quickly, and make it 450.
Do you see what happens when you are unfaithful? You begin to lie to people. You begin to craft ways. Unakuwa, I like that word. Unakuwa mtapeli. unaanza kutapeliwa, unakuwa a kingei, a con man, a con woman, a thief. These are the people we rebuke every Sunday. Why? Because of your unfaithfulness. So now you have to lie. Bwana sifiwe. Siulizata nani tulikuwa na yeye jana. Now kukua. Nijunajua. Bwana sifiwe. What happens thereafter?
Then he asked the second, and how much do you owe? 1,000 bushels of wheat, he replied. He told him, take your bill and make it 800.
Look at this man.
The master commended the dishonest manager because he acted shrewdly. For the people, okay, what just happened? For the people,
for the
of,
people
this world
of this world are more
shrewd in dealing with their own kind than are the people of
Don't
the
light.
Don't
get confused over this scripture. What is it saying? The people of this world are more shrewd in dealing with their own kind. With their own kind. That's why he's commending them in their own systems. Are you understanding me now? He's commending them in their own systems. And he's saying, this is how they behave. So now, when you find yourself behaving in that way, which system are you in? It's not the kingdom system. You are in another system. When you find you are changing receipts, it is because you have believed God doesn't have the capability to bless you without lying. It is because there are some other people. When you find yourself unachunia mtu, tuelewane, it is because you are dealing with people in their own systems. So you also know which system you're operating. The Bible says some honor me with their, but their hearts are. Talk to a neighbor and just look at them. Don't talk to them. Right now they're emotional. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. I said hallelujah. City Lighters Church, God is calling us to be faithful men and women. Bwana sifiwe. Ase bwana sifiwe. Ukianza kupigia HR, procurement manager, muulize niaje, kuna kachai nimekuekea. For us, we like to bless people. We wacha. You know what you are doing. People in upstairs are not saying amen. I think it's touching them. It's because you are not operating in the kingdom system. The kingdom system says you wait. But you don't want to wait. What do? You start cheating. Go on, go on, go on. Go on. I tell you.
Tell you, use worldly wealth to gain friends for yourselves so that when it is gone, you will be welcomed into eternal dwellings.
Go on.
Whoever can be trusted with very little can this, also be
this,
trusted
this one you need
much.
To read it quick, really slowly. And as you're reading it, if you're able to tap your neighbor with your elbow, would be good, would be really good. If you can just stretch it and tell them, Ebutusome, verse number 10, let's read it together, one, two, go.
Whoever can be trusted with very little
can also be trusted with much. So there's a condition there. This is Jesus Christ speaking. What is he saying? If then little things we cannot trust you. Wachana na Mercedes Benz. Wacha Range Rover. Wachana na mambo yati big office in a corner somewhere, I&M, you are overlooking Uhuru Park and you are watching and you are... Bwana sifiwe. If you cannot be faithful with a small Amen. What is he saying? What is he saying? Whoever can be trusted with very little. Not just little.
Very.
So sometimes you can overlook them because they are. Wapendo, umetap neighbor. Mwambie hii. Mwambie hii ni scripture, by the way. Mwambie hii. Scripture. Can also be trusted with much. Whosoever.
And whoever is dishonest with very little,
will
also be dishonest with much.
We, if you are cheating fuel for 2,000, writing 4,000, na ulieka fuel ya? So me collab wewe na pump attendant. Umeandika ngapi? Let me tell you, even if we pay you a million, you will still do the same thing. Because whosoever is unfaithful with very little things will also do what? Be dishonest with what?
Much.
With much. Talk to a neighbor slowly. Muulize, by the way, the little things, how have you been doing? Ebu, give yourself a score. Muulize, by the way, give yourself a score. Muulize to give yourself a score. And tell them, by the way, we are in church. We don't lie. Upstairs, sioni mkiuliza. Upstairs, uliza. You are unfaithful with other people's children. Ukitukitoka tu hivi umemtuna. Wewe, kuja. Kuja. Wacha ni kufundishe tabia ujafundishwa. Nikirudi hivi na shaga. Hey, where are the kids crying? Sayume, amemkazia macho hivi. Hata sijui ni kama ameanguka tu. We. If you are. Ebu tuendele. Ebu tuendele. Because we need to finish this thing. 10 minutes is the major emoji. We are reading together. Want to go? So,
if you have not been trustworthy in handling worldly wealth, who will trust you with the true riches?
Viatu mejaza kwa closet. Kweli kabisa utumiangi. Ni wasting too. Ukipata tu pesa kidogo. You know, I saw a meme just the other day. Ukipata tu pesa tu? Unatusumbua. I saw a meme this week of you ya pesa kidogo that the guy has gotten some money. Now amekia ngombe fan. You know, ataki ngombe zipigwe na joto. Bwana sifiwe. Look at a neighbor closely and tell them, hey neighbor, are you faithful with money? Upstairs, I'm not hearing you. Ask somebody and tell them, are you faithful with money? Look at what the Bible says. If you are not faithful with money, who will entrust in you true riches? Do you know what are true riches? True riches are things that don't end. Because the truth never ends. So the true riches, I want to tell you, is riches beyond what you can imagine. Now, you're not even faithful. Ukipewa 100K. Unatembea huku town ni kama bwana sifue. Sema ebu kata hiyo smoki na uweke nini? Na uweke kachumbari. Unauma hivi ya kwanza unamrudishia unamwambia weka ingine. Kwa nini kachumbari ni kama kitunguu imekawia, imelala. Leta ingine ndali pia zote. We. Nikikuliza vitu kwa nyumba yako ni, what are they for? Even you can't explain. Nilipita hivi nikasikia inaniita. Wacha kuitika. You have a choice. Wacha kuitika. Kikuita imiambie, get thee behind me. Wacha tuendele, wacha tuendele. So, if you have not been trustworthy in handling worldly wealth, who will entrust over you, who will trust you with true riches? Then the third one, this is the last one.
And if you have not been trustworthy with someone else's property, who will give you property of your own?
Just because the car is not yours. Sema hii ni 4x4. Haisikiangi mashimo. Ni gari gani hiyo ilijengwa ya mashimo? Hii haisikiangi mashimo. Ni gani hiyo manufacturer alikuambia hii? In fact, itaki barabara, inatakanga mashimo. If you cannot be faithful with other people's, unaingianga job vile unataka. You thought I wouldn't get you. I'll get you. Mnafaa kuingia 9. 10:30 unatuma message. Jam huko Mombasa Road. Where? Oh, juu sisi wenye tulifika, tulifikaje? Ama all of a sudden unakuwa mgonjwa. Nimekuwa na kahede kingine kutoka Saturday. Hakaishi. If you're not faithful with other people's property, who will trust you with yours? And that's the reason why some of us don't have companies yet. Because you are not faithful with other people's companies. That's why the idea of a company has not come. Because when God looks at you from heaven, he sees what you do. Unaingia vile unataka. Kiingia kwanza, kitu ya kwanza ni chai. Tasikuwa nimekunywa chai. Hii ofisi ya mnunu wangi mandazi na mkate. Look at a neighbor and tell that neighbor, neighbor, ask them, have you been faithful with other people's property? Bwana sifiwe. We trust you with an opportunity like the ones that the people we've trusted here. Bwana sifiwe. Wacha nisiongee sana. Bwana sifiwe. For you, it's just handling people. Way. It's a principle here Christ is telling us. That if you're not faithful with what? Allow me to make a statement and then I'm going to start here next Sunday. I'm going to start here next Sunday. Allow me to make a statement. Take me to the... Yes. So, as we begin to look at faithfulness, I want to contrast it with two things. With a miracle and what we call the providential blessing of God. So, what a miracle is... A miracle is an occurrence in the physical world when God suspends or overrides natural laws to do something outside. Okay. Yeah. What happens is that what we call a miracle is when God suspends the natural laws of nature. Natural laws. And suspends, and what does he do? He steps out of them and provides for you a miracle. Like maybe you're supposed to go through the process of, hospital and things like that. And what God does is that as somebody lays their hands upon you, you don't need to go through that process. What does he do? He overrides that process by doing what? Handing you over a miracle. So many times it is instantaneous. Many times it's instantaneous. But there's something else called the go to the next slide. There's something else that is called the providential blessing of God. This is when God accomplishes his divine will, not by suspending or overriding the natural laws, but by taking all the elements of nature or natural laws and binding them together like a master chef. What happens? Go on. Go on to the next one. In a way, God achieves his divine purpose over our lives, but never interrupts. You've lost something. You've lost something in that statement. Let me read it in my notes. Let me read it here. It's better. It is when God accomplishes his divine will, not by suspending or overriding the natural laws, but by taking the elements of the natural laws and blending them together like a master chef. In a way, God achieves his purpose, but never interrupts the natural or the normal. He pulls together the natural and the physical elements, and over time,
They work together for his greater good. That's why the scripture says, what does it say? And all things work together for good. For those who do what? Love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. So a miracle happens instantaneous. But in the providential blessing of God, takes time. Because what does God do? God pulls together all the elements of the world, of the natural laws, blends them together like a master chef, and then he provides for you what you would call a providential blessing. But many times we don't see it because this one takes time. That's why God starts you with a Mutumba shop. You don't see where he's taking you, but he is pulling the natural resources for your own benefit so that they can work for your good. Because it is not about the Mutumba business. It is about the people whom you will meet in China. And those people are in your destiny somewhere to catapult you from selling Mutumba into becoming a person who imports things. That's why you've got to be careful and patient and faithful with the relationship that God brings in your life. Because in his what we call providential blessing, they are in your path somewhere, and they are supposed to provide for you an access that now you don't see. So we look for a miracle, but there is an already miracle happening in your life. Because what God is doing is using what is present to bring you into what he desires you to get into. So he's sending you for cell group. You are not going. What you don't know that is in that cell group, he has prepared a man, a woman. But because we're Wednesday night, lazima umalize series. You are missing out on his providential blessing. Because you cannot see how the elements are working together for your own good. That's why, ladies and gentlemen, many times for you to see the faithfulness of God in your life, you have to look back. And see, that's why that person needed to come into my life. They needed to come into my life because they were the ones necessary for opening that door. I didn't see it then. And you even thank God. You say, guy, I thank God that I did not. I had an idea to dismiss that person. But I did not dismiss them. God helped me not to dismiss them. Kumbe, what you don't know is that that person was in your path, provided by God. And all you needed to do is to be faithful, even when you cannot see it. Some of you tunakuambia, serve here in church. You cannot see where is this thing going. Where is this thing going? What you don't know is that it is in that service that God will form something out of it that will bless you. Let me tell you a story. How I owned my first car. I had been serving for years. I had been walking home. Walking home. Because there was not enough resources. So there were so many people around me, so I needed to distribute what I have and bless others. So I didn't have enough. So I began to, you know, and I couldn't tell anybody, but I was walking home. As I walked home one day, one of the guys in whom I had blessed came with a car. He got a car. Came with a car. And he said, Percy, we don't want to see you walking again. From today, we don't want to see you walking again. I'll be picking you and dropping you. As that is happening, somebody else has a dream about me for 2 weeks every day consistent. And this is what he said. This car, you've ever seen like these movies where the cars are talking? What is the name of that movie? It's called Toys. Cars. My son likes it. The car would talk to him every day and tell him, take me to George. I don't belong to you. So every night he came with his wife. It's a true story. And he was here the other day. When he comes, I'll give him an opportunity to tell you the story. How did that happen? One day he called me. He told me, Percy, I need you to come and pray for me. Why? I said, what is the problem? I need you to anoint my chicken house. Why? Somebody came here, akafunga kuku, hazitagi. So kuku zinakufa because mayai imejaa ndani. No, I don't also understand it. But mtu alifunga kuku. So kuku zinakufa. Kuku zinakufa. Wakiulizwa kuku inakufa juu ya nini? Ni juu mayai imejaa hadi kupa kwa shingo. Mayai imejaa. Wanapata mayai toki. Mayai imejaa. So sasa kuku yezi. Kuku inachokiwa na mayai ndani. You know when you hear such things, you're like, what? Why should I go and pray? And I would have easily dismissed. I took the anointing oil. I told my senior pastor, I'm going there. He told me, you go. I went there and prayed for the chicken. Let me tell you, zili taga. You know, that week, there were crates. Because now, the chickens were also not resting. We need to get rid of this thing. Ka. So now listen, the issue is not even the chicken. It is what happened when I went there. When I went there, I told him, this guy is nice. I touched it and I left. For 2 weeks, the car. Kumbe the chicken were tied for my own sake. The chickens were tied for my own sake. I just needed to be faithful with God's anointing and go there and release the chicken, then touch the car. Ladies and gentlemen, from the day I touched the car, it became cars. It started talking. Take me there. The guy brought the nini. He brought me the logbook of the car and he told me this car. He gave it to my senior pastor and told the senior pastor, please give it to George quickly because I can't stand another dream of cars talking. My wife is here and many others who know that story. And the guy has even been here to church quite a number of times. He's not a young guy, but he's an old man with about 5 children. He's an old man. So it's not that he jokes, it's true. The car was talking to him. All I needed to do is to be faithful with the little thing. And what little thing is that? Go and untie the chicken. So sasa wewe umeitiwa ka job kadogo. Unasema with my credit. Mimi. Kumbe, what you don't know, it's not about the sweeping of that nini. It is because of the people whom you are going to interact with as you sweep. Because maybe it is as you sweep, somebody will ask you a question, and the way you will answer, you are structured to answer in a certain way. And the day you answer it like this, he says, who is that man? Who is that woman? Who is that young man? I came to talk to somebody here today to tell you, be faithful with what God has given you. Can I stop there? Ladies, I need to stop because we are way ahead of past time. But I want you to, next Sunday, you have to pull somebody here and tell them, be faithful to come to church today. Because you need to hear these 3 levels that Jesus Christ talks about. I haven't even started. I just wanted to show you the providential blessing of God that sometimes you don't see it with your natural eyes looking ahead. So you will dismiss people. You will dismiss companies. You will dismiss opportunities because they don't come in the shape and manner the way you know how. And so, City Lighters Church, I'm calling you As we begin to talk about faithfulness, open up your heart. I said open up your heart. Because the reason as to why God is talking to us about this thing is because he knows what he has set in your path. That you need to hear this thing so that you don't dismiss it when you see it. And I'm going to teach you about faithfulness. And you know, when we talk about faithfulness, we only think on one angle. And we're going to touch on it. But it's not just that. Even, in fact, Jesus Christ does not even address it. He addresses it in three levels. Small things. Faithful with money. And faithful with other people's property. And so I've come to talk to you today here. To tell you that the reason as to why you see these kinds of messages coming to you is because there are opportunities that are coming. And when those opportunities come, they need to find you faithful. Lord, help us. Help us, Lord. Help us, Lord. Lord, we've not even today defined what faithfulness is about. We've just contrasted it with a providential blessing of God that sometimes we may not see. Because as you pull the laws of nature together, Lord, sometimes we don't quite see it. Like a puzzle, we don't quite see how that part fits into our lives. And so sometimes we dismiss several things, certain things in our lives. Friendships we dismiss. And we end up missing out on opportunities. Lord, today, we're asking you to help us. Help us, Lord. Help us. Help us that we will be found men and women who are faithful in the dealings of God. Lord, help us not to be like this man in whom the rich man comes and says, "What is this that I hear?" I'm calling you to account for everything that I've given you. But Lord, we will be like Jesus Christ himself who accounts for the 12. And he says, "I have not lost any of them apart from the son of perdition." And he says he has kept the 11 in whom God you gave him. Making him to be a faithful man. Lord, we pray that we will be found as men who are faithful. For whoever is faithful with little will be given rulership over much. Whoever is trustworthy with worldly wealth will be entrusted with true riches. And whoever is faithful with other people's property, he will get his own. So help us, O God, in these things. That in these three levels, as we discuss them, Lord, we will turn out to be faithful. We thank you. And we praise you, O God, for today. For this we pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and everybody say it. Amen. Talk to a neighbor who is next to you and tell them, "Neighbor,